Hey, welcome. Jay Nicholas at the Caddisfly Angling Shop in Eugene, Oregon. We're going to tie a fun little, I'm going to call it a trout spey. This is a, come on, it's a summer steelhead fly. It's going to work for all kinds of stuff. So let's get going. I have a Gamagatsu size 4. Use a 4 or a 6. It's an octopus hook on a 30-pound crystal fireline. And I got it wound in there nicely, and I think the science is going to come here and confound my belief that super glue helps that. It's not doubled over. Nobody's going to pull that out. So, this is going to be a fly that's buggy. It's minnow-like. It's sculpin-like. It just looks like something you ought to eat. And how do I know that? Well, because I asked the trout. Actually, I saw this fly on the dreaded internet. And I don't remember who did it, but I tip my hat to them. This is Angora goat. And I don't even know if they used Angora goat or not. But the fly looks so buggy to me, it just, you know, I got over 50 years tying flies and fishing. And sometimes you look at a fly and you just know. You just know. It's going to fish. And this is one of those. So I thought, you know, I'm going to copy that. So this may not be an exact copy, but it's...
there was enough out there. I mean, I felt like it should have been eaten.
My version of a really buggy-looking fly to swing for trout or steelhead. So, butt of... that's a fluorescent... fluorescent orange. Excuse me, this is a hen pheasant feather. Nice, you see it's got nice little webby, buggy, soft. We're going to make a collar of that right here at the rear of the fly. And I'm not going to, I usually trim that part first, but you know when I do, darn thing sometimes pulls out on me, so. We're not taking any chances today, and I'm going to try to fold this. But you know what? It's not letting me really fold it, so I'm just going to pretend I am and start winding and see how my hackle behaves. It's doing really nicely. Thank you very much. Very nicely. So this fly, what kind of water do you fish this in? This wouldn't be a fly I'd choose for lakes, although it's got enough wiggle to it that, you know, if you're out in one of those lakes where you're in a float tube and you're just kind of kicking around and letting a beadhead bugger swim along there behind you, you just might find that this is very effective. I wouldn't be surprised. So, got my little rear section there. Now, so I want to just have a little bit of a waist in here. It's not really going to show up, but I really like this Lagerton peacock flat braid. It makes me feel good to have it in there. Besides, you know, if I suppose a fly might fish if I just did a coating of black thread there, but how much fun would that be? Oh, this looks so much better. Oh, of course. So I like this flat braid. It's very peacockish, if you will. But it's very, it's a lot more durable than the peacock is. Okay, now I've got to get some action going here in the front. And the action in the front is going to be a little tiny dubbing ball, and then some ostrich, and then another soft tackle. But this ball is going to be a little bit smaller. So I'm working on getting my Angora goat here ready. And I just find it easier to twist this up rather than to spin it on with my, to do a noodle. I like to spin this on, but a chunky noodle would work just fine too. Okay, there we go. Oh, yes. You know, it's funny, Angora goat is something I used to tie with Angora goat a lot back in the 70s. And I've just gotten away from doing. And then I saw some flies that other people were using it recently. I thought, that's not fair. They rediscovered a material that before I did. Really, really quick to follow them. Okay, olive ostrich here. I'm going to put some olive ostrich on. And this is actually going to be mostly on top. And I'm going to do this by feel. Try to decide how much to put on. I'm going to put this much on. And how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 fibers. I'm going to take a look at it. So it actually looks just right, but knowing ostrich as I do and knowing what happens when it's wet and I know that this fly, it's going to like having almost twice as much as I put on at first. Okay. The other thing is, with a little bit more, this fly is going to know without any uncertainty what's up and what's down. This hook is going to tell us what's down, and the ostrich will tell us what's up. So this fly will ride true in the water. Now this is a grizzly marabou soft tackle feather. And I got this off of Hairline offers them. I think you can order them loose as well. The patches are more expensive, but I guarantee you, you get one of these patches and you will not be disappointed, and you will tie so many flies. You'll just be aching from the smile on your face. So I like to tie this guy in by the tip. And what this marabou soft tackle does a couple things. It puts some delightful wiggle and motion on this fly. It also covers up the ungainly appearance of those ostrich butts. I'm going to tie a little nice little micro head on here. And by the way, this is Lagerton 95D thread. I love it. This is another one of those things. I used Lagerton for years. Well, first I used Nymo, then I used Danville's, then I used Lagerton. Oh no, Unithread, then Lagerton, then Vivas. And now I'm going back through the list again. And they're all good. I love them all. But the Lagerton is I go through phase where I love it because it's very fine, it's very strong, and it's also lies really flat. So here we go. I hope you like this. I'm going to give it a little spin in the vise here so you can see it from different angles. I'm going to get over to the side and I'm going to give it the wind test. You know, I haven't had this fly within 200 feet of water yet, but I guarantee the fish are just out there licking their chops. Pull it out of there. Here you go. Thank you.